Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Joe Delaney. Welcome to the 22nd annual Eve of Solemn Remembrance. Our program will begin with a half-hour musical interlude with the Malloy Group. It will conclude with a stirring revision by the Staten Pipes and Drums of Going Home. Then we will begin our concelebrated mass with His Excellency Peter Byrne as our main celebrant. Without any further ado, I would like to proudly and once again present at the Eve of Solemn Remembrance the Malloy Group. Thank you. To close our musical interlude, we are proud to present an organization that has been with us since the beginning, the Staten Island Fights and Drums, who will conclude our musical presentation by coming into the church, playing Going Home. Ladies and gentlemen, the Staten Island Fights and Drums.
Thank you.
world matters.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to all sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Give glory to your Son, so that your Son may glorify you. Father, they are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known so that the love with which you loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
At his audience, September 12, 2001, he said,
I invite you all to join me in commending the victims of this shocking tragedy to Almighty God's eternal love. That's really what we do tonight, is we think about, we remember, first of all, these people who passed away, who were killed that day. If you look on the internet, as I have recently, you can find short biographies of all the many people who died on 9/11. And what's striking about it is oftentimes, obviously, their youth and their vitality. They were all seem to be very involved, people who were full of life. So that really kind of inspires you with many feelings. One about one sadness, obviously, but also a reminder of, you know, life can be, the fact that life can be taken from us very suddenly. It's not always biographies of unknown people that I've read. I think the time like this of man Donald Foreman, he was the sports director of the Conception Parish Stadium, where I was at the time. He used to videotape all the sacraments. You say videotape, talk about passage of time. And he would use the fundraise to support the sports program. He was a Port Authority police officer who usually worked in Battery Tunnel, but had a meeting that day in the towers. His memory is still vivid in his generosity. But everyone here has a story similar, I'm sure. We do absorb two really obligations toward the deceased. One is to remember them, to think about what we can learn from their lives and profit from that learning. But the other thing, as Catholics, we are called upon to pray for them. We do believe in purgatory, a state of purification love that takes place after death, in a mysterious way to reunite those deceased souls, especially when we pray for them. A second thing, the Pope said in that same allocution, may God give courage to the survivors, may sustain the rescue workers and the many volunteers who are presently making an enormous effort to cope with such an immense emergency. When you said those words, I couldn't have been thinking of the fact that, as we mentioned the names tonight, we'll be mentioning names of people who died after that day from the fact or the result of what they were doing, digging through that rubble, the diseases they contracted. But of course, we remember in a very special way the generosity of all of those who voluntarily gave up their life to save others. We know that the most tragic day in the history of the fire department of the city of New York was also the most heroic. When all those men, not only the firefighters, but the police officers, and all the rest of the first responders, all those who voluntarily faced death, knowing they were willing to sacrifice their lives for the good of others. That's an example that's eternal. It's passed on especially to the younger people who were not even born when this took place. But that was an act of generosity that stays with us. Sometimes the most tragic events we know can bring forth the greatest qualities in people. Another thing that the Pope said in his talk when receiving the credential of Ambassador Nicholson was this: in order to survive and prosper, democracy and its accompanying economic and political structures must be directed by a vision whose core is the guiding and dignity in inalienable ways of every human being from the moment of conception until natural death. When some lives, including those of the unborn, are subjected to the personal choices of others, no other value or right will won't be guaranteed, and society will inevitably be governed by special interests and convenience. We know that the Benzonite dilemma is inspired by a desire to protect our lives, and in many ways we have to
We have to do it ourselves. Each in our own way, hope this sacred city has to promote the culture of life by our words and by our deeds, at every stage of life, from conception to natural death. Finally, Pope John Paul said, in his talk on the 12th, even if the forces of darkness appear to prevail, those who believe in God know that evil and death do not have the final say. Christian hope is based on this truth. At this time, our prayerful trust grows strengthened. That's why the final thought that we carry with us tonight. We do remember in sadness this terrible event of 23 years ago, but we do that in a spirit of hope. We had that reading, the first reading, how St. Paul talks about, eye has not seen nor ear heard, but God has prepared for those who love them. With great trust and mercy of God, great hope, we entrust the souls of these departed, so many of whom died so heroically, into the merciful hands of God. We pray for them, we pray for ourselves, that all these who may be little and loved, that we will reunite with them within one day in the eternal happiness of heaven.
Please be seated while we recite the litany of names. Those who perished both on 9/11 by the horrendous diseases since. And I begin. I stand here tonight where Jim Smith stood for many years, a very dignified man, one of the founders of this liturgy, who stood here each and every 9/11, 9/10, 4/9/11. Almost selfishly, as I laughed about that, because he really wanted to read the name of his most beloved cousin, which I will have the honor and privilege to do. And so we begin. Terence Andre Aiken. Peggy Giuseppe Alario. Jacqueline Delaney Aldrich Frederick. Christopher Amoroso, PAPD, Laura Angeletti, Dostino Apostle, FDNY, Frank Thomas, FT, Aquilino, Louis Arena, FDNY, Adam D. Arias, Greg Atlas, FDNY, Louis Aversano, John J. Pagliacci, Catherine Bantis, Walter Moran, and here's that name I went through, Jane Ellen Bailey, Jerry Barbara, FDNY, Paul Vincent Barbaro, Arthur T. Barry, FDNY, Diane Gale Barry, Carlton Bartels, Michael Ernest Meekman, Denise Lenore Benedetto, John Patrick Bergen, FDNY, Brian E. Dilcher, FDNY, Carl P. Beanie, FDNY, Susan McKino, Mary Catherine Murphy, Buffalo.
Michael J. Clark, MDNY. Anthony Colatinato. Sandra Canati Grace. John Jack Connolly. Robert J. Cortese, MDNY.
Thomas P. Cullen III, FDNY. Robert Finn Carotello, FDNY. Lawrence E. Curia. Beverly L. Curry. Thomas Dennis Enos. Edward A. Dietrich, FDNY. Michael D. Diario, FDNY. Scott Matthew Davidson, FDNY. Edward J. Day, FDNY. Azucena De La Torre. James P. DeBlaze. Jason Christopher DeFazio. Vito De J. Dilio. Michael D. Rienzo. David B. DiRubio, FDNY. Edward E. Simino, the third. Michael June E. Esposito. Matthew Diaz. John E. Farr. Carl DeFranco. Donald J. DeFranco. Deborah Ann DiMartino. Stephen Patrick DeVito. George Is Pasquale, FDNY. Joseph D. Pilato. Neil Matthew Dollar.
Joseph E. Jr., FDNY. Kathy.
Christopher Mosulo, FDNY. Peter James McGowan. Richard C. Byrne. Mario Madon, Jr. Troy B. Nelson. Brian Ness. Philip Paul Ogden. Joseph J. Ogren, FDNY. William S. O'Keefe, FDNY.
Woods, David T. Woody, Myrna, Esquita, Lucio. Captain John Michelle. Lieutenant Timothy E. O'Neill. Firefighter Kevin Lennon. Firefighter Lloyd Stewart. Firefighter Stephen J. Riley. Captain Carmine C. Cantolino. Lieutenant Patrick Whalen. Firefighter Richard Tangretto. Firefighter Andrew Garciulo. Lieutenant Richard Estreicher. Firefighter Anthony Malfi. Firefighter Anthony Arachi. Firefighter George Wilkin. Firefighter William Hodges. Firefighter Timothy J. Burke. Richard Mahogan. Leonard Henderson.
Thank you. Oh, son, I need that chance.
time he was afraid, and entered willingly into his house. He took bread and giving thanks both, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
Blessed Joseph, his spouse, the blessed apostles, and all of us.
live and reign